this presentation is based on Google Refine again, okay? So we're trying to add as much knowledge about Google Refine as possible in these days that we have together. And my goal is that given a latitude column and a longitude column, I want to find out what the country is. And of interest to me is to store the country code. All right? So, what are some traditional ways that I could go about doing this today? Well, there's a lot of online web services where you can put in your latitude and longitude and you can get back some information about the country, municipality, district. You guys saw some of that presented by John yesterday in playground clip, right? Remember that? Now, a lot of those services, they're also available online as what they're called web services. So the difference between what John showed you yesterday, that's an actual web application interface where you can drop your latitude, longitude into boxes, click submit, and it spits out the result. A web service, well, you interact usually over HTTP. A RESTful web service is you're able to basically include your latitude and longitude inside a URL in the format, in a particular format, and it'll give you back a response in something like JSON, XML. So I'm going to give you a quick demonstration of one such web service, all right? This is the complete list of web services available from GeoName at the moment. You can see that they've got one web service for country code. It will give me responses in XML, JSON, and text. Then it gives you a nice bit of documentation to explain what it does, what type it is, and it gives you an example. Now, it is essentially just a call from your browser, in this case. And there you go. In text format, I've just been given the ISO country code for my latitude and my longitude in decimal degrees. That's pretty impressive, isn't it? Now there's a lot of computers, for example, not humans, but computers that could make these calls to automatically discover information such as ISO country codes so that they can automatically be inserted into the data or onto a web page. So how can we use this service inside Google Refine? Well, Google Refine has a very nice feature that allows you to add a column by fetching a URL to a web service such as the one with GeoNames that I just showed you that lets you get an ISO country code in two-letter format. Alright, so before I do this, what's my goal? My goal is I want to take my latitude and my longitude, for which I have values sometimes, and I want to automatically create a new column that contains the country code. Alright, so first step. Since I like to use dollar report terms as my column names, and that's recommended best practice, I'm going to look up what the dollar report term is in country code. Does anybody remember what it is? No? usually what I do is I do a text search. There it is, country code. Now there's always recommendations, right? As John basically explained when he introduced this to you the first time, there's recommendations. There's a lot of standards out there, but what standard does Robert Moore recommend for entering a country code? Well, reading the definition here, I see the recommended best practice is to use ISO 3166. Two-letter country codes. Can you all see that? Alright, so the whole point is I wanted to know what to call my column name using a long code term. And it's indeed country code. So let me explain how to add this new column for country code. And don't worry about writing down these steps because inside your exercise workbook that we're going to give you this afternoon, you're going to see some clear instructions that will guide you through it, okay? So that you can try it yourself. Right now I try it, and this afternoon you will try it, alright? So I click on that, add column by fetching the URLs. I give it my name, which is the Darwin for term name. I'll explain what I'm doing now in a second. And here comes the expression. Now to save time during the demonstration, I've written down my expression in advance. Now, a little word of warning about when you're entering these expressions. If you type something wrong, there's some validation there that appears and lets you know that you entered it wrong. Because it can be quite confusing. I remember when I was working with somebody yesterday at the back on Google Refine, we were missing double quotation marks and it just meant the entire thing didn't work. So you have to be very careful when entering that. But essentially what this is here, well, it should be very familiar to you, right? It's essentially what I have here. It's my web service URL. The only difference is that the values for latitude and longitude, they're coming from my Google Refine spreadsheet. And so Google Refine's expression language allows you to extract the cell's contents, the cell's value dynamically. And so you can see here, for my first row, you remember that I had latitude, longitude. And it's pulled it out, and it gives you an example preview of what it would look like, okay? Now I just have to be sure to set my username on this. Okay? And just to be sure, I'm going to put that inside the browser and see what it gives me. Fingers crossed. Okay, so there's the two-letter ISO country code. The United States of America. Great. So it worked. Now, am I done here? My expression looks good. What I did here was I said, only wait 100 milliseconds between firing these calls. If I set it to something higher, and I'm waiting 5 seconds for each call, and if I have a lot of rows, well, I could be waiting a long time. But if you're also a responsible person and you don't want to take down somebody's web server, you could be nice to them and make sure that you don't hit them too hard. It's always a problem. So I'll put this to 100 milliseconds, which will speed things up this demonstration. Alright. So I'm going to press this. And what I hope to see is a new column called country code that contains my ISO country codes that were pulled from the web service. Here it goes. I submit that. You can see the completeness here. 0%. Great, that seems to have worked. So, here's my new column called country code. And here is the two-letter ISO code. It's been dynamically inserted into my Google Outline sheet. Isn't that powerful? So that way you can extend your own data by calling external services and do it on the fly, automatically. In this case, I've got 100 rows, so if I have that long, so all 100 rows, it would have updated all of them. The alternative sometimes is to do these things manually, but we are all busy people, and frankly, I don't have the time to sit through 100 manual entries of ISO country codes. Yeah, I'm sure you don't have. So, I've proven that it worked. Let's run through what I've done. I've decided what column of information I wanted. Luckily, that information is covered by DOM 4, so I picked the DOM 4 term name as my column name. And then I picked my web service. There's actually a lot of vendors for such services, but GeoNames actually seems like a very good provider and well documented. So I picked them. I made sure that my information would work, so I tested out the services and it seemed fine. And the only problem that I've had when I've done this myself is that sometimes, despite the fact that you have a lat long, you don't get an ISO country code back. So it takes a little bit of follow-up in those cases. Maybe it's in the middle of the sea. A case we looked at yesterday, actually it was smacked right in the middle of Hawaii, but it didn't give me back anything. That was this Korea service, equivalent service by Korea species. Thing. So there you have it. Is anybody really impressed by this? Or was it kind of boring? Yeah? Boring? One gentleman in the back is not even saying. Hold on, please. Okay, down.
Is it limited to countries, or can you go down in the administrative levels?
Well, if I was interested in getting other information, let's say country info, country subdivision, even if all that information comes back in a JSON response, which is basically a key value response, Google Reply has a very powerful parser features to parse out key value pairs and add new columns for each one. So in my case, I only have one piece of information that came back, which is the ISO country code. And yeah, it depends service by service, but hopefully there'll be something like that. These are the kind of things that when you play around and you find something new and maybe you would like to share it, find a way to exchange these kind of newfound discoveries. You know. I think we'll discuss that at a later date. So I'm going to look over to my panel of experts and ask what's next. Is this well enough to start? Or did I miss it?
I think one point to add, Kyle spent a lot of time to try to describe how Google Refine can use outside services to do one particular thing, and that was to provide a country code where the country is known. But you can imagine that Google Refine can make calls to every one of these things on the list, or any other service that exists out there. So it's actually true that there are services to do automated georeferencing. So it's possible in Refine to do the same thing that Kyle just did, calling a different service using a different column of input, such as a combination of the country, state, province, and county and locality, and send all of that to a georeferencing service and get the latitude and longitude back for the specific place. So the power is that Refine lets you use tools that other people have built that are available on the web. And the full extent of all that power depends on what tools people build. So what that means is that those of us who develop useful things for whatever our own project might be, if we take one extra step and make that available, like all of the things on this list, then everybody could use them through a free tool that everybody can use on one desktop when they're connected to the internet and do whatever useful thing it is that we just built. So the biodiversity community is trying to concentrate now on building such tools that are specifically targeted to helping data cleaning, publishing, and so on in the biodiversity domain. Imagine the services that CREA had. We saw a page where one of them is to do, find out what the administrative boundaries were given in latitude and longitude. That's one example. They have a web service, and their web page calls that service. If we knew how to call the same service, we could do the same thing through Refine rather than through the text box on their web page. That's just to give you a broader overview of the realm of possibilities. So the trick for us now, the one thing that people in our biodiversity domain should do, is make good lists of good tools and make that all easily searchable. You know exactly what it is that's available. But now it's kind of hard to find it.
Thanks a lot, John. So yeah, I spent a lot of time just concentrating on one such service.